Okay, let's start. Do you hear me well on the far seats? It's okay? Okay, the first part of my session will be a kind of introduction, so we can start, and then people can come and come for the most interesting part. This is the slides from my original presentation at DrupalCon Dublin. Don't be frustrated. And welcome to Drupal Camp London. I received a lot of feedback after session in Dublin, mostly about the lack of demonstrations, because it's a very known thing, such as entities and entity references. But my session is about how we can use them differently, not as way designed to be used by default in Drupal core. So I will make a really quick introduction, and we will talk about entities and references in Drupal 8 core, and then I will show you real examples how we can use WebPower and how we can combine different third-party models together to get a really powerful functionality. So let's go quickly. I'm working as a user interface lead in Acronis, and we are designing a large corporate websites. That's why I started research about all of this thing, how to join entities together to get kind of constructor. Okay, the core thing is entity. What is entity? Entity is simple. And the only thing you should know about entity is simple. Here you can see an internal representation of entities in Drupal 8 core. It doesn't look simple, I understand. But we are not going to talk about internal representation. We are going to talk about site building. And from this point of view, entities are quite a simple thing. And I will show you. Let's look at node entity. It's pretty you should be pretty familiar with it. It consists of several fields, title and body. In other words, entities are kind of molecules containing atoms. Title and body are just special kind of atoms, and combining together you can get different molecules. Behind this concept, it calls atomic design. People are coming and coming. You can read more about atomic design concept at these terms, such as molecules, atoms, and organisms, in Brad Frost's blog. But we will talk mostly about Drupal 8 representation of this concept. We have several entities built in core. This is nodes, users, terms, comments, blocks, menu items, and so on. We can create custom entities using a third-party model like ECK. It's pretty simple. I will show you. And we have an opportunity in Drupal 8 core to reference entities from other references. Like on this slide, you can see we can create a custom field, offers, and we can reference to other entities from this field. And this is where entity reference appears. The reference gives us a power to combine different entities together by referencing one from another. Like on this example, we can reference user entity from node entity. In other words, we can nest entities one inside another. Here, I will stop talking, and let's see a real example of what does it mean in real world when we're building websites via Drupal interface. I created a simple setup. This is a standard Drupal installation with several modules installed. Most important entity construction kit. It allows us to create custom entities on the fly using administration interface. So I already created one custom entity named Rig, and I created several bundles of it via the interface. We will use image bundle, text bundle, and columns bundle in this example. I also created a simple content type, simple ECK and inline entity form. This is another third-party module I installed. So simple ECK have only one field of type entity reference, and I set it up inline entity form widget to display the form. So let's look now how all of this works together. I repeat again, this is only two modules. This is another is one is entity construction kit and another is inline entity form. And combining together, we allow us to create really complex pages. So let's create a page. You can see a standard interface and only one field here. This is a standard entity reference field with inline entity form widget enabled. So here we can select the bundle I just showed you on previous screen. And we can create new bricks here, or we can add existing bricks from the system. So let's create a simple page without any layout. Let it be just simple. Let's add some text. And let's add some image. The searching for image is the most important thing. Okay, we now have a simple page with two entities on it. One is a text entity and another is image entity. And it looks like this page. I disabled all theming. This is a stark theme without any styling and customizations. You can see plain entities here. This is a text entity and this is a image entity. So let's make it more complex. Let's add columns brick. Columns brick contains one special field of again type entity reference, and it allows you to hold entities inside. And we can reference existing entities, so let's put our some text entity here, and let's put our some image entity here as well. So what I did, I created this an entity of type columns, and I put two entities inside it, text and image. And now we can see we render it together because I created a special template. It's really simple. It's just outputs a table with two columns. But the things here that you can place anything in these columns. It's kind of panels or layout plugin. So you can put any entity inside columns entity. And using this concept, you can create complex layouts. Let's try to do something more complex. let's put another columns here as well. Okay, what I did, I placed one column inside another column, and I put image and text in both. So we can manipulate this in a way we want, and we can create really complex components and structures using this concept. This is a handy way, and these two modules, Entity Construction Kit and Inline Entity Form, together works like a paragraphs module. Who knows paragraphs module? Yeah, fine. Paragraphs are popular today, yeah. But with Drupal 8, we have such functionality almost in core. So today, paragraphs are most like obsolete solution. And I think in maybe 1 year, we will see how people will start switching from paragraphs to core, or probably paragraphs core model maintainers. Actually, I'm working with them together on this direction. So as you can see, the interface we will get from two models and core is almost the same as paragraphs interface. You can see paragraphs here, you can edit them in line, you can nest one entity inside another entity, you can create bundles, you can configure fields, displays. Really flexible idea. But the only drawback of this concept is nesting. Because when you start drill down in entities in like this interface, it's really frustrating. And if you have more than 2-3 levels of nesting, it's really painful. Another drawback that it will be rendered recursively, so performance is not that good. So I started thinking about how we can optimize this problem, how we can get the same flexibility and convenient way of combining different entity types together, but with more generic way of nesting things together. And as a result, better performance. And I got with the following idea. My session is mostly about this thing, about entity trees, and I will show how we can benefit from inline entity forms in SDK and this thing, entity tree. What is entity tree? Entity tree is kind of structure representing our page. It's really simple. This is one example. It doesn't matter, actually. Let's skip these slides. Flat nesting, yeah, this is a key thing. So the default way of creating such layouts, this is like this. When you nest entities one inside another, like I did on recent demo, like paragraphs works. But there is another way. Instead of nesting entities one inside another, let's do like this. Let's create a special holders for our entities, and let's manipulate them as a tree structure. So on this slide, you can see example page field. This is one field and its items. We can achieve that using standard Drupal fields. The only thing we should add here is levels. So by default, items are just a plain array of items. But to do things like this, to create a treeable structures, we need these depth or indentation or something like that. So we should know on which position item should be rendered in the tree. So so I succeed with that, and that's pretty simple implementation. I will show you now. So using plugins, I created a special field type. It's based on entity reference item. The only thing it's customized is adds one additional column in database. So our field items can hold a depth value, allowing us to form trees. So entity reference give us a power of reference entity one from another. We can use entity construction keys. We can use inline entity form. And using this customization with dev, we can manipulate the whole single field as a tree. Let's look how it looks like. So again, from conceptually, it's completely the same as we just saw. This is just entity construction kit, and this is line entity form. But it's empowered by this treeable opportunities. So what I did, I created a special content type. I named it Bricky. Bricky consists of one field of type bricks. Type bricks is exactly this type we just discussed here with treeable functionality. And I also customized a bit an inline entity form widget for it. So it's based on inline entity form complex, and it adds this dev handling for us. So let's create some simple page of type breaking. You can see here exactly the same interface. It's line entity form, not customized, but extended. Let's call it simple tree. Actually, we can add existing entities here. And now, what we can do, we can drag items here, like we reorder menu items, or like we reorder taxonomy terms. We can reorder field items of type entity reference. And here it is. Here it's rendered as a columns. We can nest things together. We can create another columns here, or put existing columns. Simple. It's quite simple. We can combine together any type of entities. We can reorder a tree like we do with menu items, like we do with taxonomy terms, and we can form any layouts. And the main power we get here is we can manipulate this structure on the single screen, on the single field, and we can do things like we can put the whole structure as a new column. So here we have one block with two columns and another block with two columns, and just by dragging the whole structure, we will change our layout as a three columns layout, and the third column is a two column layout. But you just need to reset the cache because entities are now cached in core by default. Yeah, here it is. So what we did, we just moved the whole block with two columns on one level deeper, and we have completely the different layout, but with the same entities. We can do crazy things, actually, like this. We can put columns again and again. It could be one column, it's okay. Just remember to reset the cache. Cache thing a bit annoying, but it will handle this as well by cache keys and cache contexts. That should be not easy, but once created, the page will be cached forever until you changed it again or until you reset the cache. So you can see that manipulating of this table structure is quite simple and generic way, like we do with menu items, like we do with taxonomy terms. And the flexibility here is that we can define any new type of entities. We can reference and reuse entities from page to page. And we can nest them together in any kind of things we would like to do. And everything is easy, we just need to create an entity type and bundle via ECK model in administration interface, and then just specify a template like I did here. And templates are really simple and easy because we are just manipulating of childs, so when we rendering accounts, we just iterating other entity childs and put them in columns. And we don't know what inside childs, we just render them as is using standard core mechanism. It's handy, but it can look like a simple thing, not that powerful. So to show the really flexibility and power of this concept, let's create a new website, a single page for custom layout. For example, let's have apple.com. Let's create such page. What we have here? We have a slideshow, we have a four-column layout, and we have some custom footer. What should we create for such page? We already have columns. Image is simple, image entity, we can define it via ECK, and we have a slideshow. Let's create a special entity type slideshow or carousel, and then we can nest another, for example, image entities inside it to create slideshow. Let's look how it works. I created a custom bundle, carousel, using this interface without any coding. And I created a special template for carousel. I just copy and paste the code from Bootstrap documentation page and put child items here. So what we have? We have a custom entity type carousel. We have a template which renders anything inside this entity type in slides. So what we should do now, we should create a slideshow and put some image entities inside it to get a slideshow. Let's try. Add content, wiki type, apple.com. First block is carousel. We just created a new carousel. Then we want to put several banners inside this carousel. So This is of type image and holds just a single image. We can nest things here, so two images appears inside carousel. And if it will save, yeah, we can see a carousel holding two image entities. So what I did, I just created a custom entity bundle via ECK. I copy and pasted 12 lines of code from Bootstrap documentation, and I'm able to create carousels on my website, and I can put anything inside this carousel, not just images. It could be anything, anything which can be rendered. Okay, let's continue. We also have a four-column layout here. Let's create or reuse existing columns. And put banners inside. Banners are just images again. Okay, we have a slideshow with two banners, we have a four columns layout, and we did not that much for such complex layout. Let's add footer and we will get a almost complete apple.com homepage. I just make a screenshot of footer to make it easy. Okay, here you'll get a complex layout of apple.com homepage. It consists of carousel, four column layout, and a footer, which is image. So it's really easy, and it allows us to reuse these components from page to page, to nest anything inside anything. And we can just, for example, change order of carousel and four columns like this. It's really easy. But we can do more, not just such layout. Let's try to change this layout and make it not just four columns layout, but let it be two columns layout. What I did, I added one more field to entity to allow to change the view mode of custom entities. Here is how it looks like. I added a custom field, and we can specify in which view mode to display a particular field item, which is entity. So we can create a custom view mode using standard Drupal core interface on display mode page. I created a view mode 2 for multi-column layout, and I overwrite the template for this view mode. So it is quite simple template. Get child and put in two rows with two columns. So what we can do now, we can specify view mode ID here, 2, and it should overwrite default layout for this brick. Just need to reset cache. Okay, we have a carousel with two slides. We just changed the layout from four column to two column. just by specifying one view mode. And let's go deeper and let's put the whole this structure with two column layout in carousel. Why not? You can do it just by changing the level. So just by dragging one level right, you can nest the whole structure inside carousel, and it's really easy. Just reset the cache. Okay, we have a slideshow with three entities now. First is the image banner, second is the image, and third is our multi-column layout, customized with custom view mode. So, summarizing up, this is a really flexible way of constructing the complex layouts, and the site building now really simple. We just create custom entity types, we specify templates for them, and we can put everything together just in a single field. And this is also have a great performance, because like here, you can see that the whole page structure is stored in the single field, so it will be loaded from database for one query. Without any recursion, like we have with paragraphs, like we have them nesting paragraphs inside one inside another. So, just by extending entity reference with one database column, def, we get this opportunity to manipulate of trees and to create really complex structures. And everything is powered by standard Drupal mechanisms, which is now mostly in core. And we only have here inline entity form, entity construction kit, and I put my customization in special model with name bricks, so you can download it and just install, and you only need three modules to start building really complex websites. So, just several final words. Be minimalistic. What does it mean? You don't need now popular models like field collection, or field group, or panels, or display suite, or paragraphs, because everything is in core mostly, and we can reuse this functionality to create anything you want. Of course, we can use all of these modules because we give us some functionality, but for creating complex pages with custom layout, we don't need anything of these modules. So, stay minimalistic. But stay flexible because, again, you can create any kind of pages using this concept. But remember that there are two types of content. There is a flexible content. It means that every page is different. So like landing pages, you want a different layout, different content, different structure. And entity references and tree structures is ideal for flexible content. Structured content is another type of content. It's kind of, for example, you are selling the cars and you want to have car pages, for example, 100 car pages, which are almost the same, but with different content, but with the same layout. Here you can use a display suite or some kind of such models to help here to reuse layouts from page to page. But for flexible content, it's overhead, and it's much easier to go with entity references and nesting them in trees. And don't be afraid. Experiment, like me. And you can download Blix module. I will publish it tomorrow, the most recent version for Drupal 8 core. I just presented you today. I would be happy to receive a feedback and probably your experience with them or if your website set up. And remember that we are not designing pages, we are designing a system of components. So thinking about pages in this way, like a set of entities and tree structure, will make your site more clear and transparent, because it will be a strict information structure of blocks on every page. Repeat. And thank you. Thank you. And if anybody have question, you're welcome. Actually, this is a good question, because when you have such complex structures of entities combining together, you should think about permissions, workflows, revisions, and so on, translation as well. But on the other side, it gives you more power. So you can control not just the whole page, you can control pieces of it. So for example, you can give an access for a part of page for different roles, or you can set up a workflows using third-party models for entities, not just for the whole page, but for entities, and for page of, as well. But you can control more granularly, because page consists of entities, and you can control every entity separately. This is more complex, but gives you more power here. Sorry? Yeah, probably. I will add more integrations soon. So, for example, I would like to integrate with revisions, with dynamic entity reference, so you can nest not just the bundles of one entity type, you can nest different entity types. Workflows, translation, but it is mostly well-known modules. I just need to find proper way to integrate, because all of this is just Drupal core entity, and everything that can work with entity will work with the same with this concept. Thank you. Any other question?
So with the paragraphs module, mm-hmm. I found that the inline editing wasn't working. So when it tried to save, it would crash. Do you know if this works with the inline editing or not? So like the quick edit?
Yeah. This is a good question. Because I tried this, and in Drupal 7, it works like a charm. In Drupal 8, it's a little bit different, because we have to write some custom code to support inline editing, not for inline editing itself, but for letting it know what we are editing now. Because, you know, then you have this entity reference field, and you click quick edit. It should know that you are not going to edit. You should specify in some way what you would like to do. You would like to edit each entity separately, using inline edit, or you are going to edit with tree structure or real entities. That's why it's some custom code needed here, and I think paragraphs and my solution both we will just implement this code soon, because it will be much more easier to edit pages using inline edit. In Drupal 7 it was really easy, and in Drupal 8 I believe it will be easy too, just need to some investigation here. Another thing here is that we can add support for contextual links really easily. So you can click on any part of page and click edit. It's not inline editing, but it's contextual menu for pieces of block, it's really handy as an alternative mechanism. So, thank you very much for coming, for listening to me, and if you have some feedback, reach me on drupal.org or GitHub, and use entity references and web power in your experiences. Thank you.